all have journeys in our lives, never quite knowing where they will take us. Trains have always been a big part of my journeys. Many of them started with a train ride. I'm Dr. Ruth K. Westheimer. I'm now 92 years old. I lived for about 55 years in the same apartment in New York City. I wrote 40 books. I've done many radio and television shows.
Hey, Dr. Ruth, how are you?
And I'm famous for helping people by giving them advice. But my journey started in a very different place. I even had a different name. It was a journey in which I had to move across lands, learn new languages, make new friends. But it was a journey that helped me discover my courage and hope and made me who I am today. That's me at the age of 10 and a half. I was born on June 4th, 1928 with the name Carola Siegel in Germany. I was an only child to Jewish parents. Even so many years have passed, I remember my childhood very clearly. In 1933, a group of dangerous people called the Nazis came to power in Germany. They hated anyone who was different from them, including Jewish people like me. They burned the synagogues, arrested many Jewish people, and even put some in camps that were like prisons. They took their freedom away. I do remember when I was 10 years old, the morning that the Nazis came knocking loudly at my door. I was hiding under the table, horrified. I heard the Nazis tell my grandmother that they were going to take my father away to a camp. They took my father downstairs. Before they threw him into the truck, he turned around and smiled and waved. I loved my father so much. I could not believe he was being taken away from me. How could I go on without him? My family told me it was not safe for me in Germany anymore, and I must join a group of Jewish children on a train ride to Switzerland. I would be safe from the Nazis there. I didn't want to leave. I had 13 dolls, I had 2 dollhouses, I had roller skates, but I knew I had to go. The next morning, my mother and grandmother came with me to the railroad station. I didn't want to lose them too, but I decided to be brave. I was so scared. But I drew up all the courage I had. I looked out and I did what my father had done. I waved at them in order to make it easier for them to say goodbye. That was the beginning of my first journey. I had such a wonderful childhood. I remember how worried I was. Will I ever see my family again, ever? While I was on the train, I was very sad, but I also knew that the other children were sad. So, to have a little bit of an easier time, I made a choice. I started singing the songs of my Jewish background, a lot of children's songs, and I made everybody else sing. The train finally arrived in Switzerland. I was very frightened. We stepped into a world where I had never been before. I remember the people peering out of their windows as we were marching down from the railroad station. We were brought to a home for children with no parents, an orphanage. I went to the woman in charge, Riesenfeld, and said, "I'm Carola Siegel. I come from Germany." The orphanage became my home. I lived there with 50 children of different ages. All the girls had to learn to be maids. Every Friday, Riesenfeld made us clean the whole house from top to bottom. Also, we had to take care of all of the younger children. So I really became like a big sister. I learned that helping others made me feel good. As the years passed, World War II began. Luckily, the Nazis let my father go back home. My parents and I wrote many letters. They were the only way to communicate. I told them all about my friends, how important we were for each other. We became like brothers and sisters. I wrote about Switzerland. The nature was just beautiful. It made me feel safe. As we grew up, the boys were allowed to go to the high school in the village, but not us girls. My father always told me that nobody can take knowledge or learning away from you. So I studied with books at night by myself. I was determined to learn, no matter what. I wanted to write to my father that I was secretly studying. He would have been so proud of me. But I was worried that Headmistress Riesenfeld would read my letters. She was strict with us, so I didn't write anything that would get me in trouble. Instead, I wrote to my parents about important moments, like the day I was allowed to go with the older children to the swimming pool in the village. I wanted to jump from the very high diving board. First, I was a little scared. I said, "You can do it." And then I jumped. I was so excited, but I imagined if only my parents could see what I can achieve. I miss them very much. No matter how sad I was, I chose to hold on to joyful memories in order to survive. I do remember, I must have been maybe 4 or 5, that my father took me to a synagogue, holding me in his arm. He bought me the best ice cream. I still remember the taste. I also remember that of all the holidays, Hanukkah was my favorite. I lit the candles right next to my parents, singing songs together. I did receive letters every week, and I sent a letter back every week. Once the letters stopped, I knew something horrible had happened. One day, a new group of children arrived. There were some small children among them, frightened children. They were skinny, with torn clothes and tired eyes. They must have had horrible memories. They had come from one of those prison-like camps that were run by the Nazis. Their freedom was taken away from them, only because they were Jewish, like me. and they also did not know what happened to their parents. I stayed in that children's home for 6 years. I arrived there as a little girl, and I left there as a young woman. I do remember that I said, I can't lose hope, but I already deep down in my soul knew that I probably will never see my family again. In 1945, we heard that the war is over. I was thankful, but still frightened. What next? What's going to happen to me? The orphanage, the thief, lists of people who had survived. They sat us down and read them all to us. My family was never on any list. The Nazis had killed some 6 million people. I was all alone in the world. I didn't want to stay in Switzerland. I knew I had to take care of myself. I was determined to continue to be courageous and begin the next step of my journey. I would build a brand new life for myself where I could choose my own path. I went to board a big ship to go to a country far away, a country I wanted to help build for Jews to live in freedom. Then it was called Palestine, today Israel. Until this moment, the direction of my life was chosen for me because of who I was. But when I stepped onto the boat at the age of 17, for the first time, I felt free. I wanted to start over, so I changed my name from Carola to my middle name, Ruth. I knew very little about what was waiting for me. But I survived. I have experienced the most difficult moments and moments of joy. Living through all of them made me who I am today. I have made all of the decisions for myself my whole life since then. I chose to continue my studies, to move to America, to have jobs I love, and to have a family.
Thank you!
My daughter and my granddaughter fill my heart with gratitude and joy. I have created a family of 9 of us, despite the fact that I had no family from the age of 10. And yes, I've lived through some tragic events, but I found courage and hope that helped me accomplish so much in my life. When I look back, I would say to that little girl that was me, something that I want to share with you too. One journey follows another one. You go on a journey, it ends, and then a new journey begins.